In our politics lead, she was one of the most prominent voices pushing the big lie on behalf of Donald Trump. But now, right-wing lawyer Sidney Powell is admitting that the big lie was, well, a big lie. Using the old, "you weren't supposed to actually believe me" defense, previously deployed by Fox News, in the face of a $1.3 billion defamation lawsuit from Dominion Voting System. CNN's Sarah Murray joins me now to discuss. Powell is basically claiming these claims were political theater, but she filed them in court, Sarah.
That's right, Jake. And you know, you point out former President Donald Trump really elevated her profile. She was known for peddling these kind of right-wing fringe conspiracy theories, but he elevated her by bringing in her into his legal team. And she was one of those voices we saw out there peddling these unsubstantiated claims about election fraud. So now in a new court filing, her attorneys are arguing these were just her opinions, that it was up to the public to form their own opinion about whether votes were actually changed by these election machines. And one of the lines in this court filing, her attorneys say no reasonable person would conclude that the statements were truly statements of fact. Now, of course, Jake, that's not how the former president, his legal team, Sidney Powell, even when she was distanced from the former president, represented this. They went out and told the American public that this was definitively what was happening.
Well, I don't know how reasonable or unreasonable they are, but millions of people believed the big lie, and there was an attack on the Capitol based on her lies, her claims, and now there might be very real consequences for voters because of these lies that she now acknowledges nobody was supposed to take seriously.
Well, there have been real consequences. I mean, I think that we have seen from the insurrection at the Capitol, and certainly just from the feedback that elected officials got, from the sentiment from many voters, people believed the big lie that the election was stolen. They believed that some of these machines had actually changed votes, even though there was no evidence to substantiate that. And we're seeing the next wave of those repercussions as we see a number of these bills introduced in Republican-led legislatures across the country that would further restrict voting rights. And we're seeing legislators say, you know, people don't have trust in the electoral process. Of course, many of these Republicans who are saying that leave out the part that the reason people don't trust the electoral process is because Republicans were out there like Sidney Powell telling Americans they couldn't trust the process without any evidence to support it.
So people are dead, people are injured, and now there is a big effort to disenfranchise millions of Americans based on these lies that, oh, we weren't supposed to believe them.
Joining us now, CNN legal analyst Ellie Hody. He's a former federal prosecutor. Ellie, you are a wicked smart guy and a wicked good lawyer. I'm not even sure we need someone as smart or as good as you to explain how just outrageous this is. This is someone who went on TV, went before courts, yelling and screaming, fraud, 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 fraud. And now she's saying no reasonable person would actually take what I said as fact.
Yeah, John, it's official. Sidney Powell is a massive fraud. That's according to Sidney Powell herself. Similarly, the whole election fraud narrative, that too is a complete fiction, a complete fraud. That also according to Sidney Powell. And like you said, as Sidney Powell herself says, no reasonable person could believe this. It's also, importantly, not a legal defense here in a defamation case. It's not a good defense, a bad defense, a weak defense. It's just not a defense. It's actually the opposite of a defense because the two things Dominion has to prove here in order to win its lawsuit are, one, the statements were false, and two, that the person who made the false statements knew they were false. Sidney Powell has now essentially come out and admitted both of those things.
Also, Ellie, I mean, is it true? I mean, didn't a lot of people believe her? Wasn't there an insurrection at the Capitol? This minor matter of an insurrection at the Capitol where people who believed those false claims stormed the building, five people dead?
Right. I mean, it's not even, there's proof right in front of us that many, many people believe those claims, not just the people who stormed the Capitol, but really millions of people across the country who continue to believe in this fiction that the election was stolen. Maybe if there's a silver lining here, maybe people will see that one of the leading perpetrators of this lie has now come out and said publicly it was a lie. Maybe we can get something out of this and correct the record a little bit.
Now, there was something to this defense, too, which may ring as familiar to some people. Call it the Fox News defense. This is an argument that Fox News, or Fox, I should say, I don't want to overstep reality there. Fox lawyers have said in defense of some things that Tucker Carlson has said. He said, would a reasonable viewer be coming here and thinking, this is where I'm going to be hearing the news of the day? Question mark? That was a lawyer for Fox. It's very similar. It's very similar to the Sidney Powell argument.
It is, John. And the sad thing is what they're trying to do is take advantage of legal protections that are given to parody, to things that are obviously meant as sort of sarcastic or humorous social commentary. For example, if Saturday Night Live or Mad Magazine or The Onion ran an article saying essentially what Sidney Powell has been saying, that this election was stolen because of some bizarre hacking scheme involving Venezuela or something, but you saw it in The Onion, you would know, okay, obviously that's a joke. You can't sue The Onion for defamation. The fact that Sidney Powell and Fox are trying to say, well, we're like The Onion, we're like Mad Magazine, I think that says an awful lot, and it's not going to work legally either.
It is interesting. It sort of did work, though, for Tucker. I think there's a difference between Sidney Powell, who is working as a lawyer making a case and working as a spokesperson for a public official, and then, you know, what you just referred to as a parody show that runs on Fox at 8.
Yeah, what Tucker Carlson is trying to say is, well, it's all opinion. Now, that's a fine line. If you're talking about what Sidney Powell did and said, you can't just take an outrageous statement of fact, this election was hacked, this election was rigged, and then just throw in my opinion on the front and be completely covered legally. Opinions are different from statements of fact. But yeah, again, it's not a great reflection on the journalistic credibility of Tucker Carlson.
Ellie Honig, thank you so much for being a great lawyer and a great mind. Appreciate it, as always.